All right, honestly, you know, we got, like, Friday the 13th, Evil Dead. If you're a teenager, don't go in the woods, especially don't go stay in a cabin there. Honestly, woods have been evil since Shakespeare, and then you add a creepy cabin that's remote and desolate. Come on. Cabin in the Woods. A lot of people have been giving this movie very high praise lately, especially due to the fact that no one saw this coming. Obviously, it looks like another crappy teen horror flick. The thing about this one is it kind of does that tongue-in-cheek Scream thing where it goes past this threshold to the point where you're like, oh, I think this is supposed to be, you know, ridiculous. And it's kind of just smirking and wink-wink the entire movie. And if you don't know that, you're not going to like it. Unless you're easily entertained by crappy horror movies, in which case you still may not like it because you might get the hint that there's something, you know, smarter going on here and you don't quite get it. But that's just gonna piss you off more. Going into this movie, you really have to know what it's trying to do to enjoy it. And if you do know that, it's actually a very entertaining movie. I mean, it still has all the stipulations that I think the studios go through to check off for making horror movies nowadays. You know, gratuitous nudity and violence, which is cool if it's done right, and here it's done better than most other horror movies. But, I mean, you can tell that there's kind of something layered under that. I don't think it's quite that genius what's layered under it. Just the fact that there is something under there, it makes it a much more laudable movie than I think than otherwise. Use the term, but yeah, it's definitely like a meta horror movie. There's very, very few of them, but when they do come out, you know, they are pretty refreshing. Despite the fact that you know what it's playing at, it's actually still very entertaining. Pretty scary at times, even though I personally don't get scared that much. It's jaunting, which is the most you can say for a lot of horror movies anymore, because genuine suspense and scares, you don't come by much anymore. You get a little jumpy. And for the reason that it is a meta movie, oh god, even the alliteration, oh jeez, oh, I feel like a pretentious asshole. But for that reason, the average horror, gory horror movie goer might not enjoy, because it's weird as hell. It's definitely more like Scream than it is like a kind of funny horror movie like the Evil Dead movies, which are kind of insurpassable in that category of horror movies that are just smart but ridiculous and just tree rapes and stuff. You can't get past that. You're either gonna like it knowing what it is, or you're gonna not know what the hell's going on and miss a lot of it and hate it. Even for knowing what's going on, I still think it's just pretty good. I'll give it an 8 out of 10, but it definitely deserves that. Honestly, like, if you're a big-breasted girl, or if you're under the age of 20, stay out of the woods. I mean, if you're ugly, you probably go in, like, 20 feet, maybe a little more, because apparently killers aren't interested in you. And please, for the love of God, do not read from the fucking Necronomicon.